What's poppin', everybody? It's your boy Joey back with another video. As you can tell by the screen, we are going to be diving in to Assassin's Creed Embers. This is the small 20-minute clip that I told you about in the last episode of Assassin's Creed Revelations, where you get to see Ezio's life after he is retired. In my opinion, it's a great, great thing. It's a beautiful story that's told. There's not much for me to explain here, except it takes place in 1524, and you get to see, like, everything. Lineage? What the hell is that? I'm going to take a look at that in a moment, but our priority, that is intriguing. I have never seen that before in my life. Hold on. Yeah, nice crotch view. Sorry. But yeah, I've never seen this lineage thing. What the hell is that? That is... Okay. Maybe we'll watch that as well at some point, but we're going to watch Embers first. That was what this episode is going to be. And I know the camera angle is kind of crap, and I don't have the best camera quality, but I'm working with what I have, and that's all I can really do. But yeah, we're going to see what Ezio's life was like in that there. Lineage. I feel like this is, I feel like if I had to take a guess, Lineage focuses on, I want to say Giovanni, Ezio's father, because Assassin's Creed 2 takes place in 1474. So, I'm going to look more into this later, but we're just going to dive right into Embers. I don't want to look at Lineage anymore. We're going to dive straight into Embers. Let's do it. What the hell did I just do?
I am taking Marcello into town.
To see Machiavelli's play.
Ezio, his play closed 3 weeks ago.
I missed it.
We are visiting your sister. Keep an eye on Flavia, okay?
Si, of course.
We will be back soon. Ciao, amore mio.
A più tardi. Be safe.
I don't know if there are any subtitles, but I don't want to press any buttons to mess it up. But I guess Ezio married Sofia Sartor. And I guess Machiavelli put on a play. He must have missed it. Just an old man living on a farm. He has his kids. Oh.
Flavia, tesoro. Stay where I can see you.
The sun burns his old man eyes. You can hear the rays of sun. Birds chirping. If I'm correct, that assassin's name is Xiao Jin.
I do not know what else to say. I'm sorry. I do not want any part of this.
I want to understand.
Understand what?
How to lead, to rebuild my order.
No, for me that is over. Benito, now I think you should go.
Ezio. She has come a long way. Xiao Yun, did I say that right? Would you stay for supper? Grazie. Good. We have a spare bedroom. You're welcome to stay a few nights.
Xiao Yun wants to rebuild her order. If I'm correct, it's part of the Chinese Brotherhood. Ezio doesn't want any part of it, though.
Are you okay?
I cannot seem to leave my past behind me. I started this act of my life so late, Sophia. I knew I would not have enough time to do everything. Now I worry I do not have enough time to do anything.
Pretty sure he has a son and a daughter. Flavia, or Flavio, I don't really know how he pronounced her name. And I'm pretty sure he moved back to Florence.
Yun! Xiao Yun! Get out!
The wind! It opens the door!
Fuori!
Don't go in my office.
I was wrong.
See, I think you need to go.
My name is Ezio Auditore. When I was a young man, I had liberty, but I did not see it. I had time, but I did not know it. And I had
love, but I did not feel it. It would be 30 long years before I understood the meaning of all three. I want to understand, like you do, to help my people.
I was an assassin for a long time, Yun. And I know that at any moment, someone could come for me, or my family. Do you see? This is why I must be careful. I usually hire people to help me with vendange, the grape harvest. But... Indra, let us get something to eat. Lucky if these last three seasons. This way, I want to show you something. It is nice, no? Piena di vita. Half my family was murdered in this piazza, right there, 45 years ago. But now, see it like this, full of life. I cannot help but feel content and satisfied that so much pain has faded away. The life of an assassin is pain, Yun. You suffer it, you inflict it. You watch it happen, with the hope that you can help it disappear in time. Terrible irony. Yeah. But there you go. All right. I'm to drag this old man back to his villa.
Too quiet. And Ezio can sense it too. She's got this. That was awesome! Hell yeah!
Hurry!
It was my mentor's wish to meet you. We left China together, in secret, with these men. They caught him in Venezia.
Who are they?
Servants of the Emperor Jia Qin. I was born a concubine, but my mentor freed me when I was young. We returned later to save more girls, but they were... The Emperor is a cruel man. He prefers Ling Qi to beheading.
Ling Qi?
Slow process. Many thousand cuts. Then dead.
Slow process of killing. Just a torturous way to kill someone.
Pack some bags. You must stay at Machiavelli's tonight.
What happened?
A misunderstanding.
Give me just a moment.
fought the Borgia. Revenge drove me forward. And my first impulse was to aim for the head. In time, however, I learned that those who inspire fear have more devoted followers than those who preach love. Killing Rodrigo and Cesare would have accomplished nothing without some equal measure of fraternity. So I spent many years teaching men and women to think and act for themselves. First in Roma, then Constantinople. Love binds our order together. Love of people, of cultures, of the world. Fight to preserve that which inspires hope, and you will win back your people.
It will take a long time. Long time.
If you do it right, see. Get some rest.
Well, you're a big man. And you have friends. She's got this. Whoa. That was some Matrix shit right there. Nice. You still got it. Oh, the hook and run from Revelations, I saw that. The hell kind of gun is that? Dude's firing a cannon. Nice. He's a badass. Gets knifed right in the eye and doesn't even blink.
It's a long way home, no?
Much to see along the way. Thank you, Mentor.
Here. This may be of use one day. No. Only if you lose your way. You should go.
Mm-hmm.
We will be back just after dark. You should have stayed home.
I am home.
We will be right over here.
Al diavolo. I hate this damn city. I wish I was in Rome. I hear the women there are, like ripe Sangiovese on the vine, you know? Not like here, Firenze.
I don't think Firenze is your problem.
Prego? Coraggio, vecchio. Get some rest,
When I was a young man, I had liberty, but I did not see it. I had time, but I did not know it. And I had love, but I did not feel it. Many decades would pass before I understood the meaning of all three. And now, in the twilight of my life, this understanding has passed into contentment. Love. Liberty and time, once so disposable, are the fuels that drive me forward. And love, most especially, mio caro, for you, our children, our brothers and sisters, and for the vast and wonderful world that gave us life and keeps us guessing. Endless affection. Sophia, forever yours, Ezio Auditore.
And that is the end of Ezio's story. Flavia Auditore, I was right. So, that was, his daughter. I don't really know what his son's name was. Wasn't mentioned. I would assume he had a son, because there was two beds there. I mean, the other one could have been Xiaojun or Xiaojin. Hopefully I was pronouncing that correctly. So it basically just shows his life after he was done as an assassin. He, as he said in his final letter there, I had time, I did not know it, I had liberty, I did not see it, and I had love, but I did not feel it. And many years would pass until I would finally understand the meaning of all those things. And love was what kept him, Sophia, his family, his assassin brothers and sisters together. It's a beautiful message that he's trying to convey. But that's the end of his story. I've never seen this before. So, if I watch it, think of it as like a prequel, because it's in between the time frame of 1459 to 1476. Sorry. So in 1459, I'm pretty sure that's when Ezio was born. And by the time of 1476, that was when his father was killed. I think. I'm pretty sure that was when his father was killed, and so were his brothers. So I guess it's just Ezio as a kid, and his father as an assassin. And based on that background there, I would assume Rodrigo Borgia has some play in this thing. And I looked it up online. It's about 35 minutes long, so I'll probably do a separate episode of this. I had no idea it was a thing. So, yeah, but that's it for Ezio. I mean, we'll probably learn about his beginnings in this, but that's how it ends. And he saw there he had a heart attack in Florence, and that's how he died. He died at 65. Some people think that the man that sat next to him on that bench was a secret Templar. I don't know if that's true or not. There's been plenty of theories saying that it is. Some say it's not. I don't really know myself. But yeah, that's it. I want to say thank you guys so much for watching. It always means everything to me. I hope you enjoyed this little small little movie. I thought it was interesting. If you have liked it, then hit the like button. Share with your friends and family. Subscribe if you haven't already. Hit the notification bell so you can know when I'm uploading next. And I'll see you guys in the next